Look at this beauty, 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 beauty. Hola amigos, my name is Ulises and today's video is for a Moroccan chickpea stew. S-T-E-W. So I hope you stay until the end of this video. During this video, this recipe, I'm gonna tell you about the ingredients, measurements and about everything. So it's basically easy. I have a bunch of spices and... But anyway, you can do it. If I can do it, you can do it for sure. Also, I forget to tell you something. I made one video before about one tzatziki with cultured yogurt. You know, tzatziki dip. I don't know if it's good added as a garnish or as a topping to my stew. But anyway, I'm gonna add it and I'm gonna eat it. And also, I'm gonna say it again, it's easy. Easy as fun. So, let's do it. So, amigos, for this recipe, I'm gonna use one carrot, one small sweet potato. This is like one cup and a half. And what else? One garbanzo can. It's like 15 ounces, almost 2 cups. Right now, I'll use tomato sauce from being right. So I'm gonna use a little of tomato sauce, just 1 cup. If you have fresh garlic, not like this, use it. Or also if you have black fermented garlic, we can use it. If you have a garlic powder or garlic granulate, we can use it. Right now I'm gonna add 2 Roma tomatoes, 2 small. Are those small? Those are the same size. Roma tomatoes, but if you don't have this Roma, you can use other kind of tomatoes. Also, why not cherry? Tomato is tomato. Also, right now I'm cooking 1 cup of white rice. I have a little vegetable broth. Actually, I'm gonna move it because I'm gonna start cleaning my veggies. What about my spices? Turmeric, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric and smoked paprika, same portion, 1/2 teaspoon. 1/4 teaspoon of ginger, coriander, canela. What is canela? Canela in Spanish is... I'm gonna cook my rice. So amigos, my white rice, just I let it soak something like 20 to 30 minutes a little bit. Just try to remove or clean a little bit. Some kind of those grains are a little dirty. So that's why I try to rinse some cold water. That's why I try to clean it a little bit. Measurement cup. So amigos, 1 cup of white rice by something like 1.5 cup of water. Sometimes the ratio is versus sometimes 1/2, something like that. But I mean, I'm gonna place right here on the heat. And in case it needs something, I'm gonna add it later on, a little bit. So right now it's time to peel my carrot and also my sweet potato and let's chop it. So right now I'm using one long, beautiful carrot. Looks like no. And also this sweet potato. Small dice. Oh no! Just remove the ugly pieces if you have. I mean, look at these. So amigos, for the carrots, I'm pretty sure that you know how to cut one carrot, but in case that if your first time or you don't know how to cut one carrot, just remove the, you know, the end of the pieces, the end of the carrot, and also cut one side, just, you know. it shouldn't be perfect, your cut. I mean, just try to cut it. And also, if you see those kind of a small thing, slices, just eat them or cut it. So amigos, then if you see my rice, I cooked just plain. I didn't add any salt, any oil, any coriander, cilantro, any nothing. Just plain. I mean, but all the time is optional. If you want, you can add it. Onions, also garlic or other greens. Why not? Why not? Just made it simple. But I like it, something simple. It's very, very simple. So in one pan, pot or pan or saucepan, just heat it medium to high heat. Once it's hot, just added a little of olive oil, extra virgin olive oil. Just a little bit. I'm going to use this fermented black garlic. I'm gonna try to chop it a little bit, but if you know, I'm pretty sure that you know, some of those garlics looks like a paste. P-A-S-T-E, paste. So it's gonna be a little hard later. But hard but not impossible. I'm gonna chop it a little bit, and also I'm gonna saute or cook a little bit my veggies. Haha, it's going good. Why is so hard? Nice, it's good. It's good. Just a little of garlic. Oh my god, this so quickly. So if you're adding 1 clove of garlic, I mean 1 to 2 cloves, it's just a little bit, just salt it a little bit. And it's time to add your sweet potatoes and carrots. A little bit of sea salt. Can you see it? So amigos, this is very important. Don't let them burn it. Just keep it stirring a little bit, just a little bit, with your hand, with your right, with your left, whatever you're doing, just a little bit. But if you want to avoid it burn it, just reduce the heat. I'm gonna cut also my tomatoes. Let's see how it's going. Everything. Just I try to cook them a little bit, just until they are enough soft, or I mean, until they are a little tender. It shouldn't be at all. I mean, just a little bit. So amigos, after this, after 5 to 8 minutes, once you see them a little soft, it's time to add or spices. But you can add it before. I mean, while you are cooking them a little bit. So amigos, my spices that I'm using, 1/4 teaspoon of cumin, also 1/4 teaspoon of ginger, same portion with cinnamon, same portion with coriander. And this is very important, the paprika, smoked paprika, 1/2 teaspoon of paprika, and the same portion, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder. So amigos, basically just I'm mixing this, and right now it's time to add my chickpeas and also my tomatoes. So amigos, if you really notice this, like you see that it start burning your spices, add your the rest of your ingredients. Amigos, look at this beautiful chickpeas. So amigos, just add your chickpeas and your tomatoes. So just toss it very well. A couple more minutes, and right now I'm gonna add my tomato sauce. Just one cup. Yeah, something like that. Look at how it's going, everything. Wow. So then, amigos,
when you see those are good toasted or has good color, oh my god, why not? It's time to add my vegetable broth. Right now I'm adding 2 cups and let it cook between 30 to 40 minutes.
So amigos, I almost forget something and I'm missing something very important. If you like the strong flavor spices, just added a little of extra nutmeg. How much? Just a 1/8 of teaspoon, just a little bit. And also, you know, don't forget your salt and your black pepper for more seasoning, or also as you taste. I mean, something that you really love it. So anyway, just keep in mind that. I'm gonna leave you the recipe anyway below. I hope you get it, and let's do it. Just let it cook something between 30 to 40 minutes and it should be ready. So right now I'm gonna let it simmer, or gonna let it cook it a little bit more, or until those veggies are tender. Well, how looks everything. And also place back and let it cook. Look at this, amigos, my tzatziki with cultured yogurt. Look at this, after like 5 days. So amigos, let's see how it's going my stew. Look at this beauty, 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 beauty. Oh my god, the smell is spicy, but I already tried it and it's not really spicy. Just make sure, amigos, when you're cooking this, until your vegetables are tender. I mean, some of them, they love more vegetable stock, or some of them, they really love more thick sauce. I mean, it's up to you. And right now, I'm gonna plate it. Oh, wow, look at this rice. Wow, what I'm using my fingers. Perfecto. Perfecto, some rice on the bottom. And let's, wow, I love it. Wow, it smells good. I'm gonna try to serve it a little of more bunch of my veggies. More chickpeas, please. So, how I said before, I have a little tzatziki sauce or dip. I mean, I'm gonna add it. All is up to you. You can add it some Greek yogurt, or just on that way, just that's it. I mean, I'm done. Just, I'm gonna try to add a little extra garnish on the top, but all is optional, amigos. I almost forget this. A little couple of raisins or cranberries on the top also. Just a little bit. And I'm done. I hope you love this recipe. Please share this recipe if you really love it. I mean, it's very easy, very simple, and it's delicious. Actually, I'm gonna try it. Amigos, please try it and let me know what you think about it in the comments. See you soon. Peace and love. And I'm gonna keep eating.